Hi mommies, this is Tanya, Noor's mom. So today we are going to be speaking about how to protect your babies from getting bitten by mosquitoes and how to treat those mosquito bites. So we all know that mosquitoes can cause a lot of diseases, deadly diseases like malaria, dengue, chikungunya. And it is our duty as parents and mothers to protect them because there is only so much they can do. And there is only so much we can do. So, just for your information, the dengue mosquito bites you in the mornings and the malaria mosquito bites you in the evenings. Now, let's move on to how to protect your babies. So, like I mentioned, mosquitoes are usually prevalent during the daytimes and the evening times in the mosquito season, which is summers and monsoons. So avoid going out during these times, early morning, you know, when the sun is rising, and late evening when the sun is setting, because in these times the amount of mosquitoes outside are at its peak. So, and even ensure your doors and windows and everything are closed at home also, so as to avoid any mosquitoes entering your house. Now second, if you're going out, you should make your baby wear full sleeve clothes. So if your baby is small, onesies are a great option because even their feet are covered like that. If not, full sleeve t-shirts, full sleeve tights or trousers, socks if your baby is not wearing shoes. Just make sure they're covered from top to bottom. And the colors are light. You're not wearing dark colors because mosquitoes get attracted to darker colors. And the clothes should be loose fitted. They shouldn't be tight. Because, see, if this is like a tight sleeve. So if the mosquito sits here, so there's 100% probability that if he bites, his bite will go inside my flesh. But if the cloth is loose, if the mosquito sits here, there's a chance that, his bite does not enter the flesh. So ensure that you're making your baby wear loose fitted clothes. Second thing that we can do to avoid mosquitoes from biting your babies is having a mosquito net. So wherever you are, whether you're at home or you're outside, and you know you're going to be there for a long time, or your baby is going to be sleeping, say in the cot, or even while you're outside in the stroller, please ensure you have a mosquito net. Now there are many kinds of mosquito nets available in the market. One is the umbrella kind of mosquito net. So this is what I used. This is how it looks. It's a huge umbrella and you can close it actually, and it becomes like an umbrella. So this is what I use for Noor. So if you're making your baby sleep on the bed, especially when your baby is small, around 3-4 months till the baby can fit into this, I used to put this on the bed when she was sleeping, or even in the cot. So this actually fitted my cot perfectly. A 140 into 70 cot, this fits it perfectly. So this is one kind of net. Second kind of net is that you can place on the cot. It's like a canopy kind of net which covers the cot. This is what you can invest in. Or if your baby sleeps with you on the bed at night, there are nets to cover the entire bed. That you can buy. Then if you're going outside, you can have a pram or stroller net that's available. So I'm going to be linking all these products in the description below. So yes, nets are very, very important. Next is, in your houses, if you have, those mesh doors, it's a great option to prevent mosquitoes from entering. But if you don't, please try to get a wired mesh installed in your houses. So we did not have any kind of mesh. So mesh, what I mean is jali ka darwaza. So, or jali ki khidki. So we did not have these. We have only aluminium doors and windows in our houses. So when Noor was born, we realized that, we need to open the doors and windows to let fresh air come in. But there were so many mosquitoes coming in that we were so scared. That these days you have these mosquito nets which can be put on your normal doors with the help of a Velcro. I'll just show you how it looks. so that you have an exact idea of what I'm talking about. This is the kind of Velcro mesh that we got done at our house. So if you see, it can come out like this. And here is the Velcro. So they just apply a Velcro strip on your aluminium door and you can then have this wired mesh sheet. The next thing you can do is that you should avoid making your baby wear or apply any kind of strong scented products, because mosquitoes get attracted to these extremely strong scented products. So now the next point is that you should use only baby safe repellents, mosquito repellents. Now what are baby safe mosquito repellents? So usually mosquito repellents contain a chemical, especially in India, called DEET, which kind of paralyzes the mosquito when the mosquito either sits on it or inhales it, and then eventually dies. So this is actually harmful even for us, and very harmful for babies, because anyways their organs are so immature. This can cause breathing problems. So for babies, it is advised that you only use those baby safe repellents, mosquito repellents, that have no DEET, DEET. So I will give you a few options of these. So now there are various things available in the market. There are patches, baby patches available. But to be honest, patches don't work, whether it be on us or on babies. So please don't invest in those, from experience I'm telling you. Then there are fabric roll-ons. This is a great idea, especially when babies are small and you can't apply anything on their skin. So fabric roll-ons are a great idea. So I use the Mama Earth fabric roll-on, and this is the Mother Spush anti-mosquito fabric roll-on. So both of them are DEET free and they contain essential oils like eucalyptus, lemongrass and neem. So they're absolutely safe to use and even safe for your baby. Then Goodnight also has one fabric roll-on which is very safe for babies. It is DEET free and contains essential oils, so you can also check that out if you do not like these brands. Then other than fabric roll-ons, there are mosquito repellent gels, mosquito repellent sprays that are DEET free and have essential oils and are safe for babies. Both I think Mama Earth and Mother Spush have them, so you can use those. Then there are vaporizers. So vaporizers are those machines like All Out, Good Night that we use at our houses. But don't use the regular ones because they are full of chemicals and they're very harmful if the baby inhales it. So avoid using that. But Good Night has recently come with a new range called Good Night Naturals, which has only natural ingredients like neem and tulsi and haldi. And they're absolutely DEET free and safe for babies, so you can use those vaporizer machines. And something that I use from Goodnight is this Goodnight Naturals Neem Agarbatti. So this is also a great option. So I burn it in the mornings and in the evenings when it's time for the mosquitoes to come in. So this only has haldi, neem, sarson and a few other Ayurvedic ingredients. So it's very safe for your babies and even for us to breathe. This is what I use. Please note, this is not a sponsored post of Goodnight or any of the brands. I am just letting you all know about the brands that I use and that are available in the market. And another thing which a lot of people don't know that you can do to prevent mosquitoes that I do is that you burn camphor. Camphor is kapoor. So I have this kapoor dani machine. I'll be linking it below. You just plug it in your socket and you can just take any kind of kapoor, which is camphor, and burn it here. So camphor is a great thing to keep mosquitoes away. It's very good for the baby's lungs, our lungs, and it also gives like you a zen kind of a vibe at home. So try and do that. It's a great option. But please ensure while if you are using agarbattis, they're out of reach from your babies, because they can, you know, burn themselves if your baby is crawling around. And another thing that I need to tell you is that if your baby is less than 2 months old, please just stick to fabric roll-ons. Don't go on to sprays and repellents because repellent gels, because they're not advised for babies. Less than 2 months, stick to fabric roll-ons. And even when you're applying those fabric roll-ons, don't apply it on their clothes. You can apply on their cot, side or pram, not directly on their clothes. They shouldn't be inhaling it. After 2 months, you can definitely apply it on their shoulders, near their legs or their arms. You can do that. But other than that, less than 2 months, just stick to this. And a mosquito net is a must. Post 2 months, you can go for roll-on, then gels, then sprays. Patches, don't go for them. Camphor is a great idea anyway. And your Goodnight Naturals, Agarbattis, and all of that. Now, all this was how to protect babies from getting bitten. But can we really protect our baby from each and every mosquito outside? No, right? So, our baby is going to be bitten by a mosquito sometime or the other. So now what to do about that? Number one, for instant relief, okay, just to remove the redness or to get the inflammation down, you can apply ice. Just like, you know, after vaccinations that area gets inflamed, similar thing happens when the baby, when the mosquito bites. So just apply ice. Next, what you can do is, what I do is, I apply this Mother's Sparsh After Bite Turmeric Balm. It is made from turmeric and it is really, really effective. I've used it. I used it on myself also, actually, more than anything. So, this you should definitely try out. And it contains everything natural for your baby. And you can apply it even for some insect bites. So, this is a great option. Similarly, Mama Earth also has like an after bite roll-on which contains chamomile and lavender oil. So this also works really well. So these two, and after applying ice packs, you can even apply cold aloe vera gel, because that's safe for the skin, for your baby also and for yourself also. You can apply some calamine lotion, the pink lotion that's available in the market. Or, so now another home remedy that I use, and actually this is what my nani had told me, is to apply mustard oil or sarso ka tel, and the irritation, the burning, everything goes off in 1 second. So these are the things that I do to protect Noor from getting bitten from mosquitoes, and these are the things I do to take care of her mosquito bites. So let me know if you guys have any other home remedies that you do to protect your babies. Other than that, have a great day. Keep on writing. Keep on suggesting topics for my next post. I hope this was very helpful for you. I will be linking all products in the description below. Please check out my Amazon storefront link below. And the link is also in my bio, where you will find all the products that I use and I recommend, and you can easily put them in your cart. So have a nice day, take care, and thank you. Bye-bye.